All right, my friends, let's go through a very quick solution. So we are going to first get started by writing out a select statement. We're then going to select the two columns we care about from this combined table right here, which are the title and the name. So we're going to select title and name. We're then going to tell our database that we want to get all the different rows from the books table. And then for each of those different rows, we want to somehow merge them in or join them together with a row from the authors table. So we'll say join in the authors table, so just join authors, and then we'll say on, and then we'll specify which columns should be used to create the match between each row. So in this case, we want to use the author ID from the books table and match that to the ID column from the authors table. So we could put in here authors.id equals books.author_ID, like so. Okay, so that should be it. I'm going to check my solution. And after a brief pause, yep, looks like it's great. So I could see the title and the name for each of these. Just so you know, your solution will be correct, even if you mix the order of these two columns right here. So I could put in name and then the title. In the results set, we'll see first the name column and then the title, but as far as this solution checker is concerned, the results are the same. So you'll notice even when I flip the two, I will see the different order, and I still got it correct. Okay, so that's it. Now we've barely even scratched the surface of join statements, so let's take a look at some more around it in just a moment.